Now we have finished our self-organizing map in Python. So we are ready to play with our code. So this is self-organizing map code. As you see, it's each time the weight of the grids changes and it returns, it actually stores the grid in the gridlets and it also stores the iterations. So this self-organizing map function returns, some function returns grids and iterations. Okay, so this is for saving the plots and this is for transforming it to an animated GIF from the PNG files. This part is not important for you in terms of the algorithm, how the algorithm works. It is just for visualization. Okay, now we can, so this is the, for example, you have two centers here. Let's change a little bit. For example, let's make it 0.5. And this is also 0.5. Okay, this is not what I wanted. So 0.9. Okay. 0.9 and 0.5. Let's make it like this one. Okay, there are two poles. Here, two clusters, and there are some anomaly points. So this is our data. Okay. So now I will run this sum function, and I will visual, and I will here. This is it will return every grid in 10th iteration from 0 to 200 iterations. We will see the grids and iterations, and I will use the function to store the plots, and then I will transform it to a GIF. So let's run this. It will take a little time. So actually, this function actually works here. As you see, it doesn't show the figure, but it saves the figure with in this folder with this name iteration iterations k whatever is 0, 10, 20 like that. So it stores the PNG files there, and this takes the those files and transform it to a GIF. Let's look at the result here. Okay, so this is finished. At the end, we have this this much iteration, and this is our grid. Let's see how the grid works. So I think this is the real thing. Let's make it run again. So this is it. So this is, you see, we have the neurons. They become in the center now, and they one data cluster pulls the grid, the other one pulls the grid. So they are, as you see, they are separated now. Okay. So let's run another one. Okay. Let's make it 10,000. Okay. It will take a little bit more time. Okay. So when it finishes, actually our course in self-organizing map will finish. And I have mentioned for one application in the beginning. So this is for the moment we have done just mapping from two-dimensional grid to two-dimensional data space, but you can do it 1,000-dimensional data space. So, and if you find this corresponding map, actually, you can use this for dimension reduction. Another application could be anomaly detection. I will talk about it. Let's look if this is finished. Is this finished? This 10,000, I think it is finished. Let's run it. Okay, it should. It does every one. I don't know. The iteration numbers are a little bit different. Okay. So as you see, it becomes in between these two, and they are just pulled over. Okay, and at the end, you see many neurons are here, and many neurons are here, and some of the neurons are in between. So. If we look at here, can we see? So this is 20, 21, 10, 02. So they are here, 43, 42, 4, 4, 4. They are here. The four neurons are here and 2 and 0 neurons are here. So closer neurons are in this cluster. The closer neurons to 2 and 0 are in this cluster. The closer neurons to 4 and 3 are in this cluster. 4, 3 is here. 2, 0 are there. So so two cluster data is composed of two clusters and anomaly points. And our grid, our network is also one cluster, 4-3 cluster goes to this way, 2-0 cluster go that way. And we have other neurons here in between. So actually 2-2 is in between. So you see 2-3 is here because three neurons are here. 2-3 is here. So 2-2 is in between. So there are two here, there are some twos here, some twos here. So this is in between. And one part pulls, 2-0 pulls towards here, the four and threes pulls here. So there we have neurons that are in between. Okay, so now what we can do? Now I want to talk about another application, which is anomaly detection that you can use for self-organizing map. So we need to compute interneuron distances. And after that, the data compute interneuron distance in terms of weight. After that, the data that are mapped to distant neurons are potential anomalies. So here, for example, so if we think, for example, this data is map to this neuron, but this neuron is not in this cluster of neurons or in this cluster of neurons. So all the green points you see that are mapped to the in between black neurons, they are potential anomalies. So we can use self-organizing maps for anomaly detection. Maybe I will do another video for anomaly detection. Okay. Take care of you. Thank you for listening. So this was self-organizing map. It is a collective artificial collective intelligent algorithm. It is a kind of neural network, but an unsupervised one. It is used for dimension reduction and anomaly detection. And we have seen the Python implementation from scratch for that algorithm. Thank you for listening. See you in the coming week.